welcome back to another All About Apps edition from the Clever Root Studio. Today, we're talking about a very important part of your application, the design. What is the secret of creating an eye-catching app with a great usability? I will give you a hint. This is a result of special techniques developed by many experienced designers all over the world. At Clever Root, we widely deploy them and want to share a few tricks that may come in handy. First of all, you need to identify people who are going to use your app. In other words, learn a target audience of your product. For that, you create a fictional character's personas. Personas are composed on the basis of the data that you receive during interviewing, testing, and analyzing typical users. The main purpose of making them is to define the most common needs, expectations, and limitations of your customers. When finished with personas, you may proceed with user stories, scenarios, and storyboards. They describe particular cases of interacting with your app. The difference is that the first one gives general description, the second a more detailed one, and the third visual demonstration. For instance, if user story would say that a man orders sofa in an online shop, the scenario would describe a particular sequence of actions. The user opens an app, find furniture category, chooses a product, clicks add to the cart. Storyboard would demonstrate the scenario with a set of pictures. When we got acquainted with the typical users and defined possible patterns of their behavior, we can take some notes as for general concept of the future app. This is when writing first design techniques comes in handy. I highly recommend applying it before using any design software or online program. Instead, make a worded description of the application manually. It will help you systematize the information. To succeed, ask yourself a few questions, like what is special about the client, what is the purpose of their product, which problem do they seek to solve, how can the ideas be brought to users, and how can you make them interested and involved? Having answered, you will receive a better understanding of the project that will help you create a mind map. This technique is frequently used not only in design, but in each area which requires deep thinking and generation of various ideas. It helps arrange the gathered information and introduce it as a visual output. Mind map sets all the creative thoughts in one place and defines the scheme of the app layout. By using it, you can direct the flow of your user's experience in the right direction. Note that the draft created as a result of mind mapping still cannot be considered as a scheme of the final product design. This is just a preliminary sketch which distributes various ideas among specific groups. Based on it, you can create a wireframe the first and the rough sketch of your product. It shows the placement of different components and their interrelation. During wireframing, you create static pictures and display a complete app layout. These pictures can be further employed for building a paper prototype. This is a more progressive way to show your client how the final product is going to look and function. Without applying special knowledge like HTML or CSS, you can show what will happen after a certain button is pressed, how the screens change, and which way menu items appear, and so on. The final stage of design development is user testing. Before releasing a production version, place real users in front of personal computers and ask them to play around with your product. You can use moderated testing, unmoderated testing, or both. Moderated testing involves the presence and coordination of users' action. You may ask your testers to try one or another feature, click a particular button, or go through a certain part on the whole functionality. Unmoderated testing means that the app is used without your participation. You may provide users with some test cases, however, this method usually implies no intervention. Well, this is all for today. In conclusion, I would like to add that neither clients nor users are interested in the design techniques you use. In fact, they only care about the result. That's why it's up to you which methods to choose. Make a decision by reference to complexity and duration of the project. Also consider your own experience and experience of your colleagues. Anyhow, I wish you great creativity and hope to see you next time. To read a full article, follow the link below. And don't forget to subscribe.